Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Hyde Park Community United Methodist Church. My name is Ben Owen. I'm the music director here, and I am so glad to see all of you here today on this beautiful day. I don't know, I haven't been outside. Is it cold still? Okay, well, sort of beautiful day. Thank you for being here. It is warm in here. Just a few reminders before we begin. Please make sure to silence your cell phones or your pagers or 8-track players or whatever you brought with you today. We are recording this for WGUC. We would like to thank WGUC both for the broadcast of this program later and also for their promotional time that they have given to us. We thank the Clovernook Center for printing our Braille programs that ensure that all people can enjoy this music in its fullest, and also the Minuteman Press, who prints our other bulletins. We thank Michael Hughes, who is recording today, as well as Zeke Plymesser, who is live streaming for us, and our maintenance staff here at the church, who, if you see them, please just say thank you to them. They work harder than anybody else, I'm pretty sure. Don't tell the pastors. There is no intermission, so sit tight. And we do have offering plates by the doors. And we thank you in advance for your generosity. And we also thank you as a partner in this concert. Whether it's the 20th year you have come to these concerts or the first, we thank you for keeping organ music alive and relevant in Cincinnati. So in a few moments, you'll see David Von Baron, who make sure to meet him at the reception afterwards, which will be outside these doors. He is delightful. Fantastic organist, and you can read more about him in your program. However, just a month ago, he received his DMA from Boston University, so now he is Dr. David Von Baron. So please welcome him accordingly.
Thank you. Well, thank you all for coming to today's recital at Hyde Park Community United Methodist Church. It is such a joy to see you on this slightly warmer day, which is nice. It gives us a little inkling of spring to come. Throughout today's program, I wish to give you insights into the music that you will be hearing on today's program. So a few words about the piece that you just heard. The final movement of Dupré's Evocation is dedicated to the composer's father. Dupré wrote the evocation to symbolize three aspects of his father's personality: anxiety, tenderness, and pride. The last movement symbolizes the pride of his father, and it's quite possible that Dupré meant to evoke images of World War I, which tremendously impacted his life. Looking further down your program, we see two transcriptions of pieces written originally for piano. The two arabesques of Debussy were written by the composer when he was just 26 years old. Continuing on in your program, we see a work by American composer and organist Carson Kumin. Carson has written hundreds of works in many forms, from solo instrumental pieces to operas, and from orchestral works to hymn tunes. He has been composer in residence for the Memorial Church at Harvard since 2006. Preambolo e Toccata Energica, Opus 1442, was commissioned for my final doctoral recital in October 2022. A bold introduction fades into quiet, followed by an energetic toccata with an aria in the middle. Following that on the program will be two short works by Florence B. Price, composed between 1930 and 1940. Florence Price's music incorporates music of African American spirituals harmonically and rhythmically. In 2009, a substantial collection of her works and papers were found in an abandoned, dilapidated house on the outskirts of St. Anne, Illinois, which Price used as a summer home. The house was found vandalized and her piano stolen. What was left in the ruins were many unpublished compositions, including many organ works, two of which you will hear today, A Pleasant Thought and Little Melody. When we arrive to this piece on the program, I ask you to travel back in time to the era and the soundscape of the piece, the 1930s. But first, here are two transcriptions of Claude Debussy. Thank you. You know, they say a sign of a great audience is when you can hear a pin drop after a quiet piece. So I thank you for your sensitivity. Continuing on, in an American style of organ writing is the suite breve on Sursum Corda, a set of variations by American composer, conductor, and organist Tom Trenny. Tom Trenny is the minister of music at First Plymouth Church in Lincoln, Nebraska, and was my first organ teacher. These variations are joyful, energetic, humorous, and quite a bit of fun. In the midst of the 2020 COVID pandemic, I got an email from Tom with these pieces, and he wrote, "I hope these cheer you up." So I'm excited to play them for you today, and I hope they do the same for you. To follow will be the third of three impressions written by Carr Gaylert, La Nuit. This work was dedicated to Alexandre Guimond, who held the position as organist at La Trinité in Paris. But first, here are some fun, quirky variations by Tom Trenny.
Thank you.
Regarded as the most prolific composer of organ repertoire, there are over 1,000 known compositions by J.S. Bach. Bach wrote over 200 cantatas, of which many have survived. In fact, the next piece on the program is a transcription by Harvey Grace from Bach's famous cantata number 29. It is important to note that J.S. Bach was not only a keyboardist and conductor, but a violinist as well. In the next half of the program, you will also hear two transcriptions, Air on the G String and Ich stehe mit einem Fuß im Grabe, literally I stand with one foot in the grave, which requires the performer to play the pedals while playing the solo line on the violin. I've reinterpreted these pieces for this space using 8-foot flutes in the pedal line and a 16-foot on one transcription to undergird the singing melody that you will hear in the violin. Juxtapose these two pieces is J.S. Bach's transcription of Vivaldi's Concerto Grosso in D minor. We can hear in this transcription the brilliant ways in which Bach orchestrates Vivaldi's work, written for two violins and cello accompanied by strings and harpsichord. But first, here is Harvey Grace's transcription of Bach's famous cantata number 29. And now we pray I don't drop it. dedicated to concert organist Nathan Lauba, George Baker's Evocation II, is a flashy toccata steeped in the French school of improvisation. The work is given the subtitle April 22, 1984, which corresponds to the date of Pierre Cochereau's death. The haunting, enigmatic tonalities are rooted in octatonicism, characteristic of Cochereau's improvisations. The piece begins with 8 4-foot foundation stops and gradually builds to a deafening tutti by the end. Throughout the work, three Passion Tide chants are referenced, building to a rousing climax in E major. But before I play this final piece, I want to thank Dr. Brenda Portman for her incredible hospitality, and to all of the folks making today's production and live stream possible. I want to also thank all of you for coming to today's recital, and also thank all the folks that are tuning in online this afternoon. It's been an incredible joy to spend my afternoon with you, and I wouldn't have it any other way. So, without further ado, here is George Baker's Evocation II.